outside. There is a place called outside in heaven. All fake Christians, all not true Christians, all the Christians own in name, all the Christians own in name, all the Christians own in name, all the bishops, all the great bishops own in name, all the great preachers and pastors own in name, all the elders own, all the elders own in name will be thrown outside in the darkness where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth forever, forever. Eternity is very dreadful. It's terrible. Forever, forever. My dear brothers and sisters, you know whether you are living, being controlled by the Holy Spirit, being led by the Holy Spirit only. Or not, huh? You can clearly know whether you live being controlled by the sinful nature or not. And it is written very clearly, very clearly. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. I have been crucified with Christ. You know, and I know, and God knows, you have never been crucified. You have never been crucified. That's why you must wake up. Otherwise, you can die. Your soul can die. You can never enter heaven. Once saved, always saved is very laughable. It's a great deception. It's a great lie. A great lie. You can never enter heaven. You can never enter heaven unless you live being controlled, being led by the Holy Spirit, unless you live by faith only. My righteous one will live by faith. And if he shrinks back, I will not please with him. To him who overcomes and does my will to the end. How can you do the will of God even to the end? Without making every effort, without using your own will most powerfully and most strongly. It's impossible. From this time on, my dear brothers and sisters, in advance, let's make a strong decision to overcome all the temptations around you, all the deceptions, illusions and delusions, all the addictions, and do the will of God. Let's make a strong decision to the will of God only, even to the end. Revelation chapter 2, verses 26 through 29. And one more wonderful, nearly amazing, incredible Bible verse I want to introduce to you. To him who overcomes. And just before he said this, he said, "Here I am. I stand at the door. And now, if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in and eat with him and he with me. To him who overcomes, you must absolutely overcome. If not, you will be an eternal failure. He who To him who overcomes, I'll give the right, I will give the right to sit with me on my throne. You can sit down. You can sit down with the Lord on the throne of the King of Kings. Amen. You can rule with him, being seated on the throne forever, forever in heaven. It's really a great, a golden, golden, golden opportunity. Amen. Only God has given you, God has given you only a man who has his own free will. It's a really amazing, incredible, golden, golden opportunity. To him who overcomes, I'll give the right to sit with me on my throne, just as I overcame. Just as I overcame. Just as I was crucified. Just as I overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne. Revelation, Revelation, chapter 3, verse 21. I have been, you must be crucified. Okay? Your sinful nature. You must crucify. And it's not so easy. That's why you cry out to Heavenly Father, Father, help me, help me. Crucify my sinful nature. I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me.